been presented to prove the permissibility of commemorating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, the birthday of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the birthplace of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Finally, simple messages. All of these are dalail to commemorate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now I would like to ask those people who say Maulid is not permissible to present a single verse of the Quran, a single hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to prove that Maulid is not permissible. By Allah, commemorating the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will not find a single Quranic verse saying do not celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A Quranic verse, hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if you have a da'if hadith presented, you will not find a single narration proving the impermissibility. And we have given so many dalail proving that Maulid is a sunnah of how many companions? 30,000 companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maulid in the form of a jalsa, halaqa, taking place in Masjid Nabawi Sharif, and Maulid in the form of 30,000 companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, directly proven. Do you have any doubts? Tell me, brothers and sisters in Islam. There's nothing left, alhamdulillah. Every point I gave one dalil. For each point I've got more than 12-13 hadiths. But in this time I only gave one dalil for every point that I made.